So today I would love to share with you a recipe for a nice warm and comforting broccoli soup. We're also going to put some beans in here to make it a little bit more healthy, and it's going to have a lot of flavor. First, I want to show you my container garden, and this is what it looked like in July, and this is what it looked like in December, just to give you some comparison to the different seasons that I grow in. We enjoyed some beautiful snow, but I do not put a cover over my garden, and so I was kind of worried about my broccoli, but the snow provided plenty of insulation for the broccoli, but it really didn't grow much more. So we were expecting single digit temperatures. I decided to get down there on December 31st and harvest what little broccoli I had in the garden, and this is what I'm going to use to make the soup. And then I'm also going to use some of the lemon thyme that I dried over the growing season. And I did a complete video for you on how I do this. And I'd like to use a dehydrator. And then from my pepper container garden, I dried a lot of chilies this past year. Some that were hot and a little bit sweet. I had some new peppers like the habanada that I grew. And so I made little smoked pepper powders that turned out really nice. So all I did was I smoked those on my grill, and then I dehydrated them and basically took out the seeds and made them into a nice powder. But for this recipe, you can also use like cayenne pepper with maybe a little bit of smoked paprika, and that would be a fine substitute. So here are the ingredients if you'd like to do a screen capture with your device. They'll also be down below the video if you would like to print them out. So let's take a closer look at the ingredients. I have the broccoli. I just went ahead and trimmed off the little florets at the top. You can also use the leaves, but I'm not going to. We have the shallots, the thyme, some cannellini beans, two slices of bacon, some salt and pepper, the powder that I made, and some cheddar cheese along with a slice of lemon and some garlic along with some homemade chicken stock. And you'll also need one tablespoon of unsalted butter. So first we'll start by frying the bacon, and you'll just want to get that nice and crispy. So for your beans and your broccoli, you'll want to go ahead and divide those. I'm using the very small florets for the end of the soup. And then you'll just want to go ahead and chop your shallots too. So to my pot here, I removed my bacon slices, and I'll just add one tablespoon of butter to the pot. So I'm also using the bacon grease, and there's about one tablespoon. You really don't want to have more than that. That's all you need. We're just using it to add a little bit of flavor. Now after the butter melts, go ahead and put in the shallots, add a little salt, and then after the shallots have cooked about 2 minutes or so, you can add your garlic and add the pepper along with the thyme. And now go ahead and turn off your heat and add the chicken stock. And now we can transfer this to a blender and then add the half of the cannellini beans and then the larger florets of broccoli. And then I almost forgot to add my pepper powder. You can actually add that when you added your thyme earlier. And then we'll just give this a good blend here until all of the broccoli is broken up, and then transfer it back to your pot. And now go ahead and put in the rest of the broccoli and the cannellini beans, and we'll just heat this up for a few minutes, about 5 minutes, until that broccoli turns nice and bright green. And now it's time to enjoy it. It's just delicious. I love how that bacon adds a little bit of the smokiness along with the pepper powder that I used too. And now we'll feel a little bit guilty by adding some cheddar cheese, and then add that bacon right there on top. And it's just a nice warm and comforting soup. I hope that you can give this a try. I have a lot of other recipes for you too over on my channel. You're welcome to click that playlist button and check them out. Also, don't forget to click that little bell off to the right of the subscribed button, and you'll receive all notifications for my channel. I like to give my subscribers little snippets throughout the week of what's going on in the kitchen and the garden. As always, feel free to share this on your favorite social media platform. I sure would appreciate it. Thanks so much for watching. Y'all have a beautiful day.